channel. You guys, I just want to jump on really quick and just give you an update. I hadn't posted anything in a while. It's just been so much going on. I'm not going to make this really long. I just wanted to, you know, check in with you all, let you know everything's going okay on my end. I hope you guys are doing well on your end. Pretty much, it's just been really busy. We're about to move again, I know, but I have to move because this was temporary. The apartment that I wanted wasn't ready when I was ready to move, so I signed a short-term lease. So in about 2 weeks, I'll be going to a different apartment. It's in the same building, though, just a different apartment. So I've been packing, trying to get things ready. Yeah, we haven't been here that long, but we had enough stuff in here that wants me to pack some stuff up. Plus, this thing is in storage, too. So it's just a lot that I'm doing, just trying to get us ready because I want the move to be super easy. Because when we left the other apartment that I was in, when I first started my channel, that was not an easy move at all. So it's just been so much going on. The little one, he started school. I'm excited about that. I don't know if I told you guys, but I am in grad school, and that is another story by itself. So it's kind of got me all over the place, trying to maintain that. You know, I have my blog, and I have the channel or whatever, and then I got the kids, and it's just been a whole lot. But I promise to get some content out to you guys. I do have a couple of videos that I am editing, so I'll have that uploaded really soon. So this may be up before the other ones are up. I'll just give you a little info on it. One is the little vlog I did with the boys on Easter. I just want to show you guys playing with their basket, with them playing with their basket. And then I did something for the little one's birthday. I never really posted a lot for his birthday, so I want to just go ahead and get that out there. And then other than that, I'm just super excited because I'm like doing things different for myself. I know in a few of my videos when I did like the grocery hauls and stuff, I was telling you guys that I'm doing things so like my outer appearance can look better, and I'm like changing my eating habits or whatever. So now I am intermittent fasting. I've been doing it for a few weeks now. I really like it. I don't eat past 9 o'clock. My first meal is typically between 11 and 1. I know I should pick one time to eat, but I can't commit to a certain time between those hours because I'm super busy the moment 11 o'clock hits, because the little one has to get out of here to get to school. You know, my middle one, he's on that waiting list out here to go to school. So I pretty much do, I'm not a homeschooler, but I do homeschooling things with him because I feel really bad that he's not in school right now. But I mean, it's nothing I can do. My hands are tied. So instead of us just sitting back waiting until the fall, I just do things here with him to keep him, you know, engaged or whatever, have him read, have him write, things like that. But anyway, so back to the intermittent fasting. When I have my breakfast, I do eat overnight oats. Excuse me, actually I just ate before I decided to jump on the camera. And then this week my lunch will be mushroom tacos. I'm not going to use any like fajitas or anything. I'm going to use the romaine hearts. Yeah, I'm going to use that. And then for my dinner, I want some type of fish today, but this week I had planned on having shrimp with mashed cauliflower and either kale, spinach, asparagus, or broccoli. I mean, those are the veggies that I have, and 3 of the 4 of those that I just named are already cooked, so I need to go ahead and, you know, make that a part of my meal. I didn't prep my dinner. I didn't really have time yesterday because, be honest with you, I was recuperating from a weekend. I had a really long weekend, and it was just so much going on. But, y'all, I just want to let you know what your girl was doing. Oh, and I started back working out. You know, I had to take it easy because about 2 years ago, I was doing Zumba, because I love Zumba. And my right foot starts to bother me, so I went to the podiatrist, and they told me to take it easy because I had, like, a bone spur, some other crap going on. I started therapy and the chiropractor and things of that nature. But then I was like, y'all, I just can't be walking. I need to do something else so I can get right, you know? So I've been slowly taking my time, easing Zumba back into my regimen. I started back doing Tabo. I do get my daily steps in. Shout out to Fitbit. I live on the 8th floor, so I do take the stairs. I'll go down the stairs like it's nothing, but coming up is a bit of a challenge. So what I'll do, I'll do one set of coming up from the first back to the 8th. I'm working my way up to doing 2 sets of coming back up a day. We'll see how that works out. I just do a little weights and stuff, little challenges that I find on Pinterest just to get myself going. Also, I gave up meat. My birthday is in like 8 weeks, so I was like, let me do this 8 weeks to get snatched or whatever, right? Knowing I'm not gonna like meet my actual goal within 8 weeks, I just want to see a difference by the time my birthday gets here. So I decided to give up meat. And but I did slip yesterday. I had a breakfast sausage and a little turkey bacon, but it didn't even, I don't know, it wasn't worth it, but it was worth it. Like, it was good, but I wasn't tripping off of it. And actually, my appetite is weird because after I ate that, I didn't eat anything else. I didn't have an appetite at all yesterday. I was just exhausted. I've been upping my water intake. I do try to get a gallon in a day, and I prefer to drink infused water, you know, the detox one with the cucumbers, the mint leaves, the ginger root, and the lemon. If my water doesn't have that, y'all, I'm struggling. Also, I've been taking a couple of supplements from this company called Total Life Changes. I follow Phasion, and she's into healthy stuff and fashion and fitness, and I'll link her info below. But I did get some tea from her, some coffee, and these drops. And I mean, y'all, when I drink that tea, oh my goodness, when I say it flushes you, it flushes you. Y'all know tea and mouth, but I'm just keeping it real. Like, if you want something to flush your system out, go ahead and try that ISO tea. You'll thank me later. Also, this lady that I'm cool with, she told me about this drink called the Cravings Killer Drink. It's from some lady on Instagram. Basically, you take 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar and 2 tablespoons of lemon juice, the 100% real one, and have either 4 ounces or 8 ounces of water, and you drink that 1 to 2 times a day. Now, before she told me about this one, I was just drinking apple cider vinegar as a shot. I'll pour some in a little shot glass, drink some water, and I'll be done, right? Well, like, periodically through the day, I might have 1 or 2 more, just depending on how I feel. But when she told me about that, when I started doing that, and oh my goodness, it tastes so good to me. It tastes like tea almost. So I like to drink my ice warm. Now, I have had lemon mixed with it before, but I didn't do it a lot because my brain had me hooked on just doing the ACV. But now that I do this, I do it on the regular. Now, I didn't do it yesterday, and I'm totally feeling it today. Like, I feel so bloated. So when I'm done talking to you guys, I'm going to make me a Cravings Killer drink. And again, you're going to make that drink is 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar and 2 tablespoons of 100% real lemon juice, or just squeeze the real lemon, and you need 2 tablespoons of that. And like I said, 4 ounces or 8 ounces of water. Now, I know one day I didn't have enough time to make the tea, so I drank it really quick like a shot, and I just took a bottle of water and sipped on that until I felt the bottle of water was enough, like until I emptied out the water, rather. So, that's it. I'm just trying to make sure I touch points on everything. I feel like I'm forgetting something, but I don't think I am. But, yeah, your girl got to pack up the apartment. I've been doing a lot. I got a lot of boxes in the living room. I can show you guys some stuff when I do another video. I hadn't really been doing a lot of cleaning videos because I don't really clean the back of the house on camera because there's not a lot back there. I typically straighten that up when I first get out the bed before I go to bed at night. It's just not a lot because, like I said, all of our stuff is not here. We have stuff in storage and stuff in our storage room because I'm like, why unpack everything when we know we won't be in this location for long? So I may do another clean with me video with the kitchen and the living room. I'm not sure, but I will probably like do a pack with me video. We'll see. But anyway, if you guys have any questions, concerns, or comments, feel free to reach out to me. Comment down below. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.